Facilities management.
Even before today's meeting began, there was an announcement in Kuwait that prices for Arab oil were going up.
Many people ask me about facilities management. Today, we will discuss the origin of facilities management. The origin of facilities management can be traced back to the dawn of the Industrial Revolution. It was a period of profound economic, technological, and social change and guided the world into the modern era. It was a time of scientific management and successive growth. As the first Industrial Revolution gained momentum, general managers, under managers, and supervisors were engaged in starting of new technology projects, the implementation of new systems and processes, the recruitment and training of personnel to operate new workplaces. The growth of the modern industry led to massive urbanization and the rise of new great cities, as new opportunities brought huge numbers of migrants from rural communities into urban areas.
The modern world is a world in which business plays an important part. Office buildings and office workers are a familiar sight in every city and town.
In 1960s, American businessman Ross Perot was the first to use the term facilities management.
See, I'm the only guy that talks numbers. Mm-hmm. I love this. Nobody else will even talk about it. It's like a crazy aunt in the basement. Everybody knows she's there, but nobody talks about it.
Now, whose fault is that? Not the Democrats, not the Republicans, somewhere out.
Yes, he was a businessman, politician, and philanthropist. The office administration slowly adopted new IT systems after the Second World War and significant progress in satellite technology. Computers have revolutionized the office landscape, streamlined processes, and boosted efficiency. But there were no significant changes in the workplace until the US was hit by an energy crisis. The roads were emptied of traffic and the price of oil hit $5 a barrel overnight. It was a time when organizations started analyzing their true cost base to manage utilities.
Will be essential for all of us to live and work in lower temperatures. We must ask everyone to lower the thermostat in your home by at least 6 degrees so that we can achieve a national daytime average of 68 degrees. Incidentally, my doctor tells me that in a temperature of 66 to 68 degrees, you're really more healthy than when it's 75 to 78, if that's any comfort.
Nixon felt better at 68 degrees after energy crisis. In the 1970s, Herman Miller, the largest manufacturer of office furniture, introduced innovative designs that revolutionized office space and design.
Well, I'm walking through it right now. It's a far better environment for today's changing functions, an instant, flexible office facility that can parallel the surging, turbulent business life it serves. This is indeed the age of change.
In December 1978, Herman Miller Research brought together a group of knowledgeable property professionals to host a conference on facilities' influence on productivity, which led to the beginning of a professional organization called Facilities Management Institute. It was to advance FM as a new management science professional activity. The National Facilities Management Association was founded in the 1980s as an independent organization from FMI, which was mostly working in space planning. It was the time when the facilities management role emerged in the corporate structure. Later, NFMA transformed into IFMA under the leadership of David Armstrong, known as Father of FM. Today, IFMA has almost 24,000 members in 100 countries. In 1990s, two organizations emerged in the UK called IFM and AFM, which were working in their own spheres of control. Later, both organizations were merged, which resulted in the establishment of Institute of Workplace and Facilities Management, or IWFM, formerly known as the British Institute of Facilities Management, or simply BIFM. The year 2000 has seen a significant growth in FM organizations around the world. The global facility management market size was estimated $1.4 trillion in 2023 and expected to surpass around $1.9 trillion by 2030 with a registered annual growth rate of 4.7%. Please like and hit the subscribe button to watch more interesting videos about facilities management.